I'd like to call the meeting to order and welcome each of you here to the October City Council meeting, and appreciate everybody coming out here tonight and the ones watching at home. And we meet the third Tuesday of each month, and at 6 o'clock we work from a prepared agenda. Copies are available beside the door if you'd like to pick one up. Members of the media that are here, Roy Sawyers from Rockingham Update and Mike Moore from Mike Moore Media. Appreciate y'all being here. Item two is invocation to be given by Pastor Joel Clark of New St. Paul Baptist Church. That'll be followed by the Pledge of Allegiance, which will be led by Parker Woodall, sixth grader at Holmes Middle School, and Norah Woodall, third grader at Stoneville Elementary School, children of Josh and Kim Woodall. If you'll please stand for these two items. We got the pastor first. Mr. Epps, will you lead us in a prayer, please?
Certainly I will. Let's pray, folks. Father God, we thank you today for your mercy and your love. Thank you for protecting us today as you have every day in the past. Lord, we thank you moving for those folks up in the mountains. It's something that happened for them. Lord, we thank you for sparing our city the much trouble that could have happened here. Lord, give us grace tonight and help us to make night decisions. And we give you the praise in Jesus' name. Amen.
I pledge of allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Epps. I didn't realize he wasn't here yet. Item four is proclamations, recognitions, and resolutions. 4A is a recognition of the hair company for 50 years in business. If Kim Woodall and her team would please meet me at the front podium. Recognition for the hair company. Half a century in business is special in any institution, but for a service business like a hair salon, 50 years is an amazing accomplishment. In 1974, stylist Larry Turner started the hair company in the Professional Arts Building on Highway 14 across from the hospital. In 2000, Larry moved the hair company to its present location at 624 Monroe Street. In 2003, stylist Kim Woodall began working at the salon and is now the proud owner of the business. Kim knows exactly what has enabled the hair company to not only stay in business 50 years, but to grow, thrive, and become an integral part of Uptown Eden, the support of clients and her team of nine stylists. One of those is the original owner, Larry Turner, who to this day cuts hair for some of his very clients who first visited the business in 1974. The hair company invites the community to celebrate their 50th anniversary this Friday, October 18th from 3 to 6 p.m. at the salon with food, drinks, special vendors, and exclusive deals. Congratulations to the hair company on 50 years in business, and thank you for being part of the Eden business community. And on behalf of the city, I have a plaque to present to you.
Thank you. As much of an honor as it would be to accept this award, I cannot, because I'm not even 50 years old. I have worked for the hair company for 21 years, and of that 21 years, I've owned it for 4. So this acknowledgement and the certificate should go to my mentor, Larry Turner.
Yeah, let's do that. 50 years. A lot's changed in 50 years, but the one thing that hadn't changed is the people of Eden. The loyalty, we're on third generations of families in the hair company, and we appreciate it every day. Thank you.
Next, we're going to quickly recognize the Eden's first responders for their contribution to the Tropical Storm Helene recovery efforts. There's members of our rescue squad and fire department are here, and if you'd please stand and be recognized. On behalf of the City of Eden, we would like to thank the members of the Eden Fire Department and Eden Rescue Squad for their selfless dedication and time when they deployed to help our neighbors in Western North Carolina. I think we've all seen how bad it is there, and any help they can get is always greatly appreciated. And I know it was a hard place to go and see that kind of stuff, and I know it's something that really means a lot to the people out there. So thank you all for going and deploying to that area and serving those people. We appreciate it. All right. 4C is Proclamation of Indigenous Peoples Day. I'd like to ask Patrick Suarez to please join me, if you will. You can come around here. Yeah. How's it going?
How y'all doing?
It comes from me.
Okay. Talk about that. That's fine.
Thank you, Rita. Okay. Whereas American Indians have inhabited this continent for centuries, and from the first contact with the English settler, American Indians shared their knowledge of the land and its resources, and have contributed to play a vital role in the development of the City of Eden, the state of North Carolina, and the nation. Whereas North Carolina is home to more than 122,000 American Indians, with 8 historic tribes which are legally recognized by the state of North Carolina. Whereas the City of Eden enjoys a positive relationship with its American Indian citizens, recognizes and encourages the acknowledgement of the history, contributions, and sacrifices of Indigenous people, and honors and respects the rich cultural and economic contributions that American Indians have made. Whereas the City of Eden promotes inclusion of Indigenous peoples to ensure greater access and opportunity and honor our nation's Indigenous roots, history, and contributions. Whereas Indigenous Peoples Day was first proposed in 1977 by a delegation of the Native Nations of the United Nations-sponsored International Conference on Discrimination Against Indigenous Populations in the Americas. And now, therefore, I, Neville Hall, as Mayor of the City of Eden, on behalf of the City of Eden, do hereby proclaim Monday, October the 14th, as Indigenous Peoples Day in the City of Eden, and hereby reaffirm the commitment of the City of Eden to promote the well-being and growth of Eden's American Indian and Indigenous community.
Cindy, you getting it?
We'd just like to thank the City of Eden for giving us this opportunity. This is our third year putting on the youth powwow, which is across the street. We have it there because of the weather in April, but we would like to bring more awareness to Native Americans in this area and surrounding areas. So the Indigenous Peoples Day is just basically a day that coincides with Columbus Day to let people know that Native Americans are still here, that we are a vital part of society, and we still thrive today. So we just want people to know that we're still here. So, and it's basically the many states, many cities are putting these proclamations out, even the federal government. So we appreciate Eden for having this proclamation. Hopefully we could do it yearly and have more people here. But we do have something for you. And this is sage, and basically sage is to purify the body, purify the air.
My wife will love
so,
that.
Yeah, so well, we appreciate you. We thank you, the City of Eden.
Thank you. I look forward to the powwow.
Yes, sir. Yes,
it's
sir.
Always
yes,
a good
yes,
time.
Sir.
Yes, sir. Appreciate good to see you again, man. Thank you. Thanks for the gift.
Thank you.
All right. I'd ask a utilities manager, Melinda Ward, to please join me up here for a proclamation for Imagine a Day Without Water 2024. I'll read this and then you can do your one. Whereas the 10th annual Imagine a Day Without Water National Day of Action raises awareness about and appreciation for our most essential resource. The water infrastructure in the city of Eden delivers clean drinking water to over 15,400 residents per day and then safely returns wastewater to the environment. And whereas reliable water services are essential to the quality of life, environment, and economic vitality of the city of Eden, and a day without water would be a public health and safety crisis, limiting the functionality of firefighters, hospitals, businesses, and homes. Reliable water services help to drive a healthy economy, providing workforce opportunities, protecting business continuity, and supporting healthy and happy communities. And whereas the nation's water infrastructure is aging and in need of investment, resulting in water main break every 2 minutes somewhere in the country. An estimated 2 million Americans are living without access to adequate drinking water and sanitation. And that's probably up right now after the storm. Whereas by recognizing the true value of water in our lives, we can help secure a healthy water future for everyone in our community and for all Americans. Therefore, be it resolved that the City of Eden recognize that water is essential to quality of life, public safety, and economic health, and accordingly acknowledges the importance of raising awareness about the value of water through participation in Imagine a Day Without Water National Day of Action on October 17, 2024. And be it further resolved that the City of Eden is dedicated to investing in safe and reliable water and wastewater systems and calls on our local, state, federal partners to continue dedicating the funding necessary to protect and restore our nation's critical water infrastructure. And Melinda's got, this is your proclamation you can take. And I know you had some remarks.
Thank you.
I'll go sit down.
I just wanted to say that on Thursday we're going to be taking a moment to imagine a day without water. We do this each year to remember the role that water plays in all of our aspects of our lives. Nearly everything that we use needs water in some form or fashion in order to be, you know, in order to be created, produced, or transformed. But luckily, we only have to imagine it. But right now, we have neighbors to our west that are not only imagining, they're living it right now. You know, not just one day, but, you know, multiple days, weeks, possibly months before they're going to see any kind of improvement in their system, where they've had entire systems actually destroyed or damaged due to the hurricane that's gone through their areas. So with this in mind, I do want to thank our council for the continued efforts that they've given in keeping our infrastructure funded. I also want to thank the citizens for allowing this effort as well. You know, what's happened in the West is out of anybody's control, but at the same time, you know, we don't want to find ourselves in the same course of action in our future. So we want to make sure that everyone realizes that every dollar that's spent is doing something that's going to be benefiting the city and the future of this community. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Mayor. Thank you. Item 5 is roll call. Let the record show that all members of council are present, as well as the city manager, city attorney, and city clerk. Item 6 is set the meeting agenda. Entertain a motion.
Motion.
Second.
I have a motion to set the agenda and a second. Any further discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Motion carries. The agenda set. Item 7 is public hearing. 7A has been continued from September to this meeting and will be continued again until the November. What's the date? Do anybody know? Aaron, am I okay with just saying the November meeting?
The November meeting, council meeting.
Okay. So that one's still waiting on some paperwork. Item 7B is a public hearing for the consideration of an amendment to the CDBG-CV project to seek additional funding to repair and renovate Draper Elementary School. I will declare the public hearing open. Kelly Stoltz.
Thank you. As you all know, we received some COVID money a couple of years ago, and the original intended use for it was not able for all the money to be spent. And so we were given permission by the state, because of its importance to education and further efforts in the city, to spend that money that we had left on renovating the former Draper High School. It's where I went to they called it an intermediate back in the olden days, but it's where I went to fifth and sixth grade. The building is in a shape that with the funds we have, we can make it usable. However, we did learn that a large amount of the ARPA money was not entangled, encumbered, and so we are able to apply for up to $5 million to do additional work on the building. With the money that we have, we can make it usable, livable, all those things. But there's simple things, like, for example, the bathrooms in the building that were for students, which would be most used, meet building code. However, there's no heat and air in them. There never was. And so there are a lot of little things like that that we hope to accomplish. We can't give you an exact list of what might be done at this point until we find out from them how much, if any, additional funds we'll receive. And once that's done, it'll go through a staff committee and a designer and all of those things, and it'll come back to you all to approve. We had the bid opening this morning, or we hoped to, for the roof. We got permission to do it out of order with the rest of the building renovations. We had one gentleman show up to bid on time, and so we couldn't open. And so then about an hour later, a local roofer came in with a bid, and we couldn't take that one at that point either. So it's being re-advertised, and in another 2 weeks, we'll hopefully open those bids, and if we just have one the next time, we can open it. We want to work on getting that roof done as quickly as possible. I would ask that you all allow us to apply for this money. It's going to go somewhere, and it might as well go to help us.
Kelly, one question. How many square feet are in the existing building?
Oh, my gracious, you're going to ask me something that I don't know off the top of my head.
Well, I mean, you gave square footage cost, and I was just kind of curious how that related to the, the $5 million.
It's just a guesstimate, because $5 million is all they'll let you have.
$300 a square foot, you can build a 16,000 square foot building. Is that something we could do, something new instead of upfitting, or is that only available for...
It's totally available for projects that have already been funded.
This already being a Roosevelt building, too, would that have any encounter?
I'm sorry, I didn't understand.
Would this understand, this being a Roosevelt building, would this also help with the
It does. Funding? It's a WPA work project building, and that does help a lot.
And so that's even more supportive.
And the fact that you and I went there to school, that should make it really special.
Well, we understand, and it's very positive that the fact that we are capable of getting this and we are able to be successful with what we've been done in the past down there. And also for our recreation department, would it be a plus for that?
They will be the main user. I think there's all kinds of grant funds out there, and we can debate the wisdom of grant programs. However, if these funds are going to be shared with communities, we may as well put our projects up to be considered, is my opinion. And so I would really ask that you allow us to move forward.
All right. Any other questions for Kelly? Would anyone like to speak in favor? Would anyone like to speak in opposition? If not, I will close the public hearing and entertain a motion.
I'll make a motion we go forward with this CBD CV grant number 20V3501 for the improvement and possible redoing of the receiving grant money for this building that we now have property of.
Second.
I got a motion and a second. As far as other discussion, I just want to point out this is not to spend $5 million. This is asking to get to apply for the grant. That's all we're voting on.
Right.
All right, so any other discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed? The motion carries. Item 8, request and petition of citizens. We have none. 9, unfinished business, consideration of a commission appointments. That's mine, and I have a name to submit for that appointment, and it's Mike Quickle. And I need a motion to accept or deny.
I make a motion to accept.
There's a motion.
Second.
And a second. Any further discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed? The motion carries. Item 10 is new business. None. 11, reports from staff. Mr. Mendenhall.
Yes, sir. Mr. Mayor, members of council, I'd like to turn your attention to item 11A, the city manager's report. I'd be happy to answer any questions at this time.
questions for John? If not, copies are available here and online. Item 12 is consent agenda, non-controversial items that you've had a chance to review, and I need a motion to approve the consent agenda. Mr. Epps, motion to approve the consent agenda.
Mr. Woods took a second.
And Mr. Thank Woods you. Took a second.
Yep.
Any further discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed? The motion carries. Item 13 is announcements. Cindy, I saw you just walked in. Would you like to give us any info on the River Fest? I know we're going to do an event or a thank you something for everybody, but it was such a good event, and we're so proud of it. So
we are. And next month, I want to have a volunteer recognition for that, and we'll do a lunch and those kind of things. But in the meantime, our numbers did come in from Placer, and it came in at 24,300 people. So
what was it last year?
22, a little over 22. So
you had more than 24.
It was a lot. But it was great. It went very smooth. I think the community and visitors really liked it. We had a good variety of things. We did shuttles because of parking issues. On Friday night, they shuttled 680 people. On Saturday night, they shuttled 1,400. So for 315 passenger vehicles, they were very, very busy. And so we want to thank everybody. Thank you guys for supporting us. The sponsors, we'll recognize them as well next month. Without them, we could not do it at the level that we do it. And but thank you. And again, we'll expand on it more next month.
Thank you, Cindy. Thank you, Cindy. Friday the 25th is a treat street for Halloween candy in Uptown. And then there's a Halloween parade at Freedom Park on Saturday the 26th at 11 a.m. Anybody else have any other announcements? If not, item 14 is adjournment. If there's no objection, I would like to adopt a motion by unanimous consent to adjourn. Hearing none, we are adjourned. Thank you for coming.